Who's Lee Soo-man? Tell me about him.
Lee Soo-man, yes, he is the father of Korean pop, really. He was the head of SM Entertainment, which is one of the big three agencies, the big K-pop agencies and music producing agencies in South Korea. And they don't just produce music, obviously. They actually put together the bands from the trainee days all the way up. They make the music. They also make all of the visuals and the marketing and the merch and everything around it. They are these powerhouse firms. And Lee Soo-man was the head of SM, and he decided around the same time that Korea took, as a government, the Korean government really took on this cultural export strategy. He realized that the real opportunity for Korea was to export what he called cultural technology, which was dance groups and triangle formations and a certain style visually and a certain kind of way that Korean cultural exports would look, and a certain level and caliber of the dancing and the caliber of the film. And so to this day, when you see sort of Korean pop culture, it's sort of like, wow, that is excellent. That is on a level and a magnitude that is so much higher than any other country in the world. I mean, I remember after BTS came out and you saw them dance and you went back and watched like NSYNC.
It's not even the
NSYNC.
same.
Right. It's like, whoa, we thought NSYNC was good. You know, like they looked like clowns compared to the precision and the sort of caliber and excellence of Korean cultural exports. And so Lee Soo-man was somebody who really saw that as a strategy. And now he's back in the news because he sold his firm recently to Hybe, which is
Oh yeah, that's the big
the
one.
BTS agency. Yeah.